point at banks. How do you think they're going to pay for all those billions of bucks in fines they've been having to fork out? 4 to 5 investors, which we're told, are predicting banks are going to be continuing layoffs this year, hundreds of thousands already. So Tracy Burns and Matson Money CEO Mark Matson. Tracy, first to you. You've sort of spelled this out as our accountant here and numbers nerd. You have been going through the cost that they've been looking at, and there's really only one way to address that, and that is through layoffs and cutbacks, right?
You know, they're like hamsters on a wheel, Neil. So the government institutes more regulations, but you keep laying people off. You don't have the people to follow through on these regulations. That means, whoops, things slip through the holes, and the government fines them again. The government fines them again. In order to meet their bottom line, they got to lay off more people. And it becomes so circular. These banks just take that out of their own way, and it's all because of the government. They're not loaning money because interest rates are so low. Why would anyone give a mortgage out for, you know, 2%? So the banks can't make any money, and they can't keep people on staff. They want to keep the lights on.
Mark, what do you make of that? Because there are a lot of people who are hearing this and say, well, I really don't feel sorry for the banks because eventually they always find a way to make money, and they always find a way to keep that federal protection coming. What do you say?
Well, if you take money, $2 trillion for a bailout, you know, that's blood money. And, of course, the government's going to come down on you. And I agree with everything that Tracy said. You know, it sounds like a chapter out of Atlas Shrugged. But the mistake that most investors see or make is that they see this negative stuff and they think that now I got to get out of bank stocks. Well, the reality is that all that information is already priced into the price today. So bank stocks, financial stocks are high book-to-market value stocks. They have a lot of book value, small price, which means they have a longer-term, higher expected return.
So you're looking at all the bank stocks as attractive investments?
Yeah, because risk and return are related. If you understand the right risk, a Nobel Prize-winning study by Eugene Fama showed that companies that have a lot of book value but small prices have long-term expected returns. You know, you have to buy these things before you have the right narrative. 2008, 2009, no one had the narrative that everything was going to come back. The S&P's up 218 since then.
But, Neil, at the end of the day, they're not going to move until interest rates move. So I agree. They will eventually be a great place to be. But one, and the second interest rates move, these stocks are off to the races. But until then, they're unfortunately in a holding pattern.
We'll watch closely, guys. Thank you.